Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Grand Campaign of Medieval 2. We just crushed the Byzantines at Iconium. I mean, crushed. Primarily due to the fact that they just slung together a huge army that primarily consisted of militia with weak morale that quickly broke after their king, their general, died. So they just crumbled. Man. Tush, you're looking good, man. Your tush is the best tush ever. I can only imagine how good he's going to be when he actually becomes the Sultan. Because while the heir apparent is good, plus one command, plus one authority, plus two to personal security, the ruler bonus is just better. Okay, I guess not. Don't listen to me. I don't know what I'm doing. I only play the game. End that turn. Oh, here comes the Byzantines. I bet they want peace now. Oh, are they going to actually set up a sort of resistance for me? That would actually be awfully nice of them. Because I'm fairly sure with my glut, I believe that is the correct word, my massive army of cavalry archers, they're not going to be able to beat me in the open field. Their best chance was to take my capital. And they failed. Miserably. And now they're going to fight me in the open field? Okay. They do have three ballista units there. And Byzantine infantry. Okay, so they do have horse archers. 10, 17, 7, 12. 10, 17. 712. Okay. So their horse archers are better than mine. Okay. I can crush these armies. Easily. The horse archers might be a pain, but I have more. I simply have more. I think. I know Tush has more. He has like a whole army of them. Do we get a speech? I might start giving up on speeches if they keep sporadically breaking. Come on, I like speeches. Nope, no speech. Okay, fair enough. That cavalry line. It's gonna be delicious. They can't beat me in the open field. They can't. They can, but they can't. I'm gonna have my cavalry archers group up so I can grab them easily. And my general is going to take care of the ballistae. The ballistae. Begin that battle.
More men to the battle.
Just go in, take out those heavy infantry. You go in and take out the ballistae. We need to do that, preferably before the rest of the Byzantine Empire arrives. I would appreciate it. That would be nice, please, and thank you. Charged my general right into the line of fire. Oops.
A foe fights with horns made of clay. We are winning.
If I just
the
keep doing hit and run tactics on their ballista, they'll never fire. All right. Time to clean up this mess. This battle's gone on long enough. Stop firing the arrows, because I don't want you to waste all of them.
Only half the
I also don't want
remains.
You to kill my general with them. That would be unfortunate as well.
Behold our worthless foe.
There we go.
Unlock.
Those guys are
have left
done.
Our enemy lost. They run like children. Scour them from the field. Our foe fights with horns made of clay. We are winning the battle.
Now we can clean up the rest of this army. I don't think those little clusters of units is enough left to keep an army together
general.
After the battle. So just get
lion,
back.
But he seems more an ostrich. Let him sit and watch how true lions fight.
Are they just going to sit there? Okay. I'll take these guys out first. Byzantine cavalry. Our arrows will blot out the sun! Are they just not going to circle? Okay, there they go. Oh, they only have two of those guys? Ah, that's cute. Finish them. Go ahead and rotate this army. Our lineup got a little bit messed up at some point. That's okay. I'm pretty sure my horse archers has this. Whoa, what are you doing? Stop that. Don't do that. That's stupid. Out of there. I know I didn't have the melee attack pushed down. I have no idea what they were thinking. And they should easily be able to handle these guys. Just take out those Vardarotai. I picked the wrong region. Where nobody speaks
attack.
English.
We must act now.
The only real language. I'm joking. Don't.
Victory is well.
Don't take me seriously. Stop it.
Surely see this.
Stop.
And hurt.
Stop doing it. Don't do it. It's cheating. Yep. It's cheating. Man, these guys are actually tough. I don't know if they're so tough that they actually took down a lot of my units, or if a lot of my units just died because they charged into melee with the militia. But regardless, ow. I did lose quite a few of these guys. We'll go ahead and play nice after this battle. We'll let the prisoners go. What's his name here? Still chivalrous.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
We'll just let them get back into the city, and then we'll crush them
like
there.
Sweet nectar. Come, let us drink.
Go home.
Yeah.
And that got rid of my disrespects prisoners thing. Now we're all back up to 3 pips for chivalry. Good. Siege Nicaea. What should my consistency be here?
Lay siege.
I'll be honest, I don't really have that many cavalry or infantry. That could be a problem. I'm almost entirely. Ooh, they could have Byzantine infantry in there. What can I hire for mercenaries? You have mercenary captain. Yeah. All I can hire is not infantry. Great. Just great.
Yes, noble master. We will engage them honorably.
All right.
Has the time come to strike, mighty Sultan?
Go ahead and build a mustering hall. Your town. What can you build? A mustering hall. That's good. I need some kind of infantry. I just don't have it. It's like they're pushing me to use cavalry archers, and they probably should be doing that, but I don't wanna. Hello?
The Holy Bible may preach peace, but when it is Christendom itself that is threatened, then it is every Christian's duty to defend all.
Wow, I'm glad I didn't take Antioch.
His Holiness the Pope has called a crusade to reclaim the Holy Lands from the infidel, who would deny Christian pilgrims their right to visit the holy places. It is time for the armies of Christendom to put aside their differences and
unite under one banner. We're just about to get swamped by Christians. Have fun with that, Egypt. I don't need to hear that again. Queue stalled because we have no money. Javelin! No! I don't want javelins! I want soldier dudes! Build leather. I do need to get these leather works up so that my troops have decent armor. Ah. Tush Tush has 2 kids. And neither of them are called Tush Tush. That is disappointing. Oh well.
As my sultan wills.
You're still chivalrous, that's good.
This will be an honorable battle.
Okay, they only have 1 unit of Byzantine infantry. It's probably the one that I crushed in the field, based on how not many they have. I don't see that as an issue. What I do see as an issue is the fact that we are attacking a city and we don't have any infantry. Let's do it. Then maybe we can even sneak up and take out that other army. I'm gonna love to see this Byzantine collapse. Wait. I need to bright and sunny. There we go. I'm not gonna wait for the cutscene, the inspiring speech, because I don't think it's going to happen. Okay, I mean that's fine. Put our archers up there and spread them out a bit. And start a battle. We only have 1 infantry that's not. Okay. How about you guys just ride in, cause a little bit of havoc, shoot some dudes, preferably not my own. Much the same of how we did this last time. We'll get these cavalry archers in, just shoot a few arrows. Our archers are doing the same. And once we get through, we'll just line up our cavalry archers in here, fire against the back rows. Much like that. It's just... ow. This cavalry is taking a beating. And of course, we're aiming for the general, so we're not going to get too many kills because of their heavy armor.
Let us have reached the walls.
But that's okay. Nope. Don't stop spinning.
Curs who hide behind them.
You know what? Do whatever you want. That is my answer when the AI becomes derby. Just.
Our men are under attack.
Ah, crap.
We must act now.
Great. Suppose an argument for bringing up both rams at once. Man, if we can't get through the front gate, we're gonna have some issues. Oh, and those are the heavy infantry. Yep, they're routing. Both of the infantry units are routing. Stop that. Stop them from routing, please. This is important. Your reputation is on the line, not mine. I don't have a reputation. Just stop them from routing. No, it didn't work. Crap. They might calm down as the horse archers come in to cover. Or they're just gonna run away. That is option two, yes. Looks like we actually managed to get to the gate this time. That's good, because none of the assaults on the walls worked.
Our men have reached the gate with the battering ram.
Aw, man, this isn't good. These guys stopped. Fall back in line. Just keep falling. Keep the arrows coming. Those guys headed for the hills.
Our men have done well.
Great.
The gates have fallen.
I have so few infantry left. No, wait. I can't be stupid here. Group up, stay together. Keep firing those arrows. That ram caught on fire afterwards. You don't often see that. It's cute. Now go in. Now everybody's here. In fact, let's send you guys into.
They're under attack.
Well,
we need to act. Allah is glorious. We have taken the walls. It is time we captured this place.
Let's just slowly work our way in with the cavalry archers. And by that I mean run! Go forward! Scare them away. Spook them. actually move would also be beneficial.
Our men are under attack. We must act now.
Are they abandoning the walls? They're abandoning that wall. No, they're not. Yes, they are. Yes, they are. Archers, I need you to get up there. They are not abandoning that wall yet. That's fine. They're holding me off. I'm going to lose this battle. Okay. Tactical retreat. Gah! Crap. I knew I didn't have enough infantry, and I still decided I would try to go for it. I could have been a bit more aggressive with my general. I could have charged my general in there with my infantry. That just feels like a good way to have gotten him killed, though. Well, it seems as if we're going to be fighting the Byzantines for a while.
No.
How long is a while? A while. Also, it seems as if some of my guys have stopped retreating. Let's go back to retreating. It's best to get out now while we still have some of our army. Because we don't have enough to take it. I just have too much infantry. And our archers can't... Our cavalry archers and our archers can't beat on these Byzantine knights without extra support from spearmen. In retrospect, there might have been a way that I could handle that better. If I had gotten my archers up on the walls, I could shoot down at the cavalry and just laugh because they can't get off their horses to climb the walls. But I just feel it's best to make a tactical retreat now and not risk the rest of my army. Even though the balance of power looked like it was turning in my favor, it really wasn't. It was something like a 40 or 50% of my army of lost compared to their 25%.
Winning the battle.
Well, that's a huge bummer. What are you doing? You know what? Just go die. All of you. All of you guys running in the wrong direction. You deserve what's coming for you.
Army have been ground like wheat at the mill.
Crushing defeat. They lost 88 people to our 513. Wow. I shouldn't have put my cavalry archers in. I should have held them back. If my assault failed, then I should have retreated. I probably retreated a bit too late there.
I have failed you, men. We are beaten.
Unfortuitous.
We shall lift the siege, merciful Sultan. Noble.
They executed my prisoners.
Noble.
That's
master.
Fair.
Na'am.
Let's combine some of these guys.
Orders. Na'am. An honor.
Pull back.
Tomorrow's
lick our wounds. Wait for Tush Tush.
Yes,
honestly, that's what we should just be doing from the beginning. We should just let Tush Tush do everything. He is the hero that this story needs.
We shall not fall or flee.
Even though this is going to bleed his army a bit, because that's a huge rebel army. If I could get them, if I could just siege them down, let them come out to me, it would be better. But after what happened with the last crown prince, I don't want to risk that.
Good tidings such as these, does victory spring forth?
I know it's such a rare thing, especially with someone as loyal as Tush Tush, but I just don't want to risk it. Okay, we're gonna do that and that. Do we have a third? A second siege tower? We do not. See, even here we have more infantry. This is what we need. We just need to work on our army compositions. Start this battle. Let's go, Tush Tush. You and me. I can't attach to that wall. That's super annoying. Okay.
Our men are under attack. We need to act!
Well, if I can't attach to that wall, then I guess I can't attach to that wall. I really wish they didn't default to fire arrows. I know they look nice. They're less accurate. Don't use them. Unless you really, really need to hit their morale. Like, if the primary way you have to win is to take their morale, then you use fire arrows, or if you need to light something on fire. Everything else, just don't. Although fire arrows at night are kind of nice too, just so you can see what's going on. Oh, they came out to meet our infantry. Okay.
The siege towers are at the walls.
I'll foe think he could hide I'll meet that challenge. Sure.
Our men are under attack. Our ladders have reached the walls. May our brave lions strike these curs who hide behind them.
They have archers on the wall. The spear militia should be able to handle that, especially with the backup of these Ghazis. This, I'm a little more concerned about. But my reinforcements are coming. They should be all right. What else do you have hiding back there? You have missile cavalry hiding back there. Interesting. Oh man, this is going to be a rough one as well. All because I have horrible army composition. I have so much... I have so much horse cavalry and not enough infantry, but I don't have good infantry to back up my cavalry. At least not yet. That is the biggest tragedy of this so far.
Send your troops to take the rest of the settlement.
Let's try and, get those missile cavalry to rout before they do too much damage. It does sort of lock my troops into a vice. That's okay. They'll get over it. Or they'll die! One of them will happen.
And are under attack.
I still
we need to act.
Don't. My tactics for the horse archers in siege is just bad. I'm not gonna beat around the bush. I should stop complaining about it, but it's just bad. I'm not used to having and using so many horse archers.
Behold our worthless
and
folk.
Honestly,
our
that's
enemy general
probably my biggest issue right now.
We must act now.
Even over and beyond the fact that my economy is still currently trash. But my economy is improving. As my economy is improving, I'll feel more comfortable about fielding larger armies or taking more risks. Even though you could take a risk and still get punished for it, like, or you could take something that's not a risk and still be punished for it, like, what happened earlier.
Only half the enemy force remains. We must pray they lose their will to fight.
Do that. I don't know how I'm going to get all of you in here, but I want you all in here. I want you to keep shooting arrows at everything. I have large army sizes on, which is great. It makes for a lot of fun battles, but in sieges it gets kind of weird because your army doesn't really fit in the streets very well. Oh yeah, just walk over the spear militia. That's fine. Or spear militia, they'll hold. Even this isn't really the crushing victory that I want. But I suppose this is the early game weakness of the Turks.
We must act now.
That's pretty much what's holding me back right now. That's fair. I can't really complain about that. The early game for the Turks is supposed to be arrow cavalry heavy and not very infantry heavy, and that makes it difficult to take cities for them. And I'm having a difficult time taking cities. I'm losing more men than I would typically lose, and that's part of why factions have weaknesses, and why factions should have weaknesses. Have a bit of a traffic jam here. It's okay. Shooting those guys, yeah, that's... It would be dangerous to shoot these guys down here. Probably end up killing a bunch of my own guys. The spearmen on the wall better be careful, because I might just take the city, the town capital before... before they get a chance to fall back and protect it. Which of these guys are on the wall? Things that I should have kept in mind. Those guys. Alright, come on. Come on. Come on. There's one guy there. Don't worry about it. Just run through him. Come on. Good. Good boy. Attack those spear militia. I don't care that it's raining arrow, just do it. Boy, it's really raining arrows. Look at all those. Boy, I wish Medieval 2 had slow-mo like some of the newer Total War games has. Alright, let's speed this up a bit. It's taking a bit too long.
Wisest one, we have lost control of the city.
That's okay. I'm sure it won't be a problem. Those guys are going to rout right into death. Yep.
Our enemy flees before us.
End
like
the battle.
Great victories are like sweet nectar.
That's still
come,
more kills than I would have, or more losses than I would have liked to have sustained. Okay. And of course, we're not going to burn the settlement. Because Tush Tush is chivalrous. Although he got a trait, that might be a dread trait.
We'll
nope, no dread trait.
These are now our people's lands.
Go ahead and immediately build.
Sultan.
A road system. And let's recruit spear militia in Iconium,
died for our sins.
I guess.
For you,
can't really
many.
Build them anywhere
As
else.
My Sultan wills.
You got plus one command. That's okay. And okay. All right. Yep. Look at that. Aw, man. He's so good. Ah. Who would have thought that Tush Tush would be such a star player? I should probably just combine these Gazis. We're not going to get a chance to retrain them again until there's another holy war, and that could be a while. Because I don't know how long between... Oh, I have a merchant? Why did I build a merchant? That doesn't seem like something I would do. Well, where am I gonna put you? Ba-ba-ba-ba. 41, 54, 46. I suppose it's not really worth it, but it's better than nothing. I need to get sight up here somehow.
Yes,
I need to send
master.
A Tush Tush on an expedition. Because this whole area here is Edessa. I think? No. Adana and Yerevan. Okay, yeah. So this is my region here. It goes to here. So I need to put something. I need to put
an honor to serve.
Tower right there. Yeah, that's what it is. Man, I'm so mad. I'm so mad that I didn't get that. Oh, well. Ambitions for the next episode. We crushed our main rival in the early game now. How interesting would it have been in the future? You might not even be watching in the future. But, just in case you do, I'll see you then. And until then, happy gaming.